Welcome, welcome everyone to episode 28. Can you believe it's fall or Christmas, at least in this half of the world? I love October. I got married in October, October 18th, 20 years this year. This is Dr. Lisa Holland, and I am welcoming you to that 20th year of my marriage and to Owning Her Health podcast, yet another wonderful episode. This episode, we have Pamela Windell, a beautiful goddess from the UK, working on how to help women ignite, explore, get excited about menopause, not to think of it as the ending, but rather the beginning. We got into, anyone who follows my goddess tribe and follows me over here on the webs on either my website blog or on my shares on social media and this podcast knows that I like to go a little bit deeper into the psychosocial or the spiritual aspect of being a woman, looking at that, what fuels her on many levels of holistic health, and Miss Windell did not disappoint whatsoever. We've been connected through functional medicine and both Kajabi Heroes with that wonderful platform for delivering our online virtual courses. And while in the midst of all of this, we discuss, you know, just even getting there, getting to that point and sort of like being in that pregnant waiting stage where you know you're not supposed to be doing what you were doing. You're not quite sure what you are supposed to be doing. You're trying to make things work. So it was just such a lovely conversation. So, you know, definitely listen in and enjoy that. But I'm going to invite you even to this wonderful after hours idea that I had been getting. And this was one of those conversations where we couldn't stop talking. So we stopped the recording of the podcast and went right into an after hours, after filming Goddess Chat. And went into video and spoke about some of the demons in our back, you know, very much in line with becoming the CEO of your life and flipping that pain and making it your passion. You know, I have a lot of those leading ladies on here. Well, we took it up a notch and went into kind of what our background was, both being very traumatic. I felt like when I was talking to her, she's like, same vibe. Got there and how those stories really do bring us to the perfect place we are supposed to be, especially as we're going into our menopause years, perimenopause, really bringing things out which don't feel so good but are completely necessary, and you need to learn how to allow that. So I invite you to listen in on this episode and then go on over, if you have some time, today, tomorrow, and flip it over to the YouTube and see us. We spoke so long. Her daughter was waiting on her and walked on in, and it's just so funny. So it's just so what happens with mompreneurs. These things happen. Dogs walk in, kids walk in, and you just keep on going. It reminded me of that Facebook viral video that was going along that was kind of like mimicking what was seen on the guy who was like pushing his nanny and child out, and what it would happen if it was a woman. You just kind of like, yeah, make it keep going and keep going with your recording, no problem. So make sure that you check on in. This episode of Owning Her Health is sponsored by Mind Body Brand Academy. Mind Body Brand Academy is your 8 weeks of intensive look into who you are and what you're aligning to move you from that analysis paralysis into taking action that you feel good in your own skin, making, whether it's to start that program that you want either online or with a local tribe or starting that community, getting your Facebook messages out, basically for anything like that, to actually just jumping in and going for it yourself. Maybe you're going for a cash-based business like I did. So mindbodybrandacademy.com is your place where you can get some information on how to get unstuck and even know what courses to take. Sometimes we get so inundated with what's we're supposed to do that we end up not even knowing who the heck we are and where we're actually going. You only know where we're running from. So check that out, mindbodybrandacademy.com. All right, everyone, as I tell you all the time, buckle up, get yourself excited, download that MP3 in the car for the next car ride, a carpool, and listen in to another wonderful episode of Owning Her Health right now.
Welcome to this episode of Owning Her Health with your host, Dr. Lisa Holland, PT. Join Lisa as she starts the conversation on what it really takes to become a healthy, wealthy, and whole CEO of your life. Listen in to real talk by real lady leaders in all walks of life as they open up on personal health stories, wealth, career, and feminine abundant living. Learn how to grow by owning your body, expanding your mind, and aligning your soul with the purpose only you can pursue in this world. Happiness begins with owning her health right now.
Welcome everyone to another episode of Owning Her Health. This is Dr. Lisa Holland, and I am so excited to have another Kajabi hero, my platform with doing my courses and integrative women's health specialist, Pamela Windle from the UK. And we met, I think, through the Integrative Women's Health Institute stuff and being online, oh gosh, a good over a year ago or so. And we kind of chit-chatted on her. We were just newbies on Kajabi, and we playing with that and trying to make things work. And then she's nicely blossomed into this wonderful menopause program. So thankful that you're having a goddess chat with us today, and looking forward to all your wisdom, Pamela. Why don't you tell us a little bit about who you are and what you're doing?
Oh, well, thank you, first of all, Lisa, for inviting me onto your podcast. I feel really honored to be here. So thank you.
Thank you.
So, like you said, I am based in the UK, and today it's actually sunny, which is rare. It's actually a beautiful day today. We did meet through social networks, didn't we, and the internet and various things, and have changed, evolved in that year. Life has really improved, my health has got better, and you know, I know what my purpose is, and I am so like inspired to change how we perceive aging as women, you know, as we transition from, you know, being fertile to perimenopause and then beyond that. So that's my mission, to really just change the view of that, you know, from women and men as well, you know. So that's my passion.
That's awesome. And it's shining through. And I love that. I love, because when anyone aligns with kind of their thing, their vibe, it shines. But there's something special about a woman doing that, because we are the form of grace and beauty and, you know, curves and flow. We are kind of like the artistic side, as opposed to just structure and form, you know, linear form. And so when we align with our, you know, soul purpose or our light or our mission or however you want to term that, it's like, it doesn't just light us up. And you like could see the vitality in us. I mean, everything. I mean, I don't know if you agree, but I feel like, you know, our hair gets better, our skin gets better. It's like being in love with ourselves.
Yeah.
And finally being able to do that, as opposed to, you know, just with our role or like hoping that we get that kind of thing. Do you find that with working with women with menopause, like somehow getting them comfortable with the process of that change sort of just lights them up from within?
Yeah, I mean, it's particularly when they first come to see me, they just feel really hopeless, and you know, they don't feel strong physically or emotionally, and they've really struggled to find who they are. You know, they've lost themselves, and watching them evolve and watching them become stronger, and you can just see the face lighted up, you know, the hairs you're talking about, they start to improve from the inside, but also it reflects on the outside. It is absolutely wonderful to watch.
I know it is. So what a blessing. What a blessing to have you have them for you and for them, for you guys to finally meet. I noticed on your Facebook, you know, some of the testimonials that because you work with hypnotherapy. Like, explain your practice a little bit more. Is it one-on-ones? Are you just doing virtual? Are you doing both? How are you working it?
Yeah, so my background is really quite broad. So my early years, I was a personal trainer and a fitness instructor, you know, taught everything under the sun. from, you know, your aqua aerobics to spin to body conditioning, and then obviously the Les Mill stuff, you know, all the body pump and all that. And I loved it. And then I went to university as a mature student and decided to do psychology, but with sports science. And it was at that time that I really felt that I needed to change what I was doing. It wasn't enough in just doing, being a personal trainer. I wanted something else. And I guess that kind of inspired me to look at how we interact, you know, what we, the things we say to ourselves, and how that impacts on us as a physical being, which then led me to do hypnotherapy, and which I love. And that combines hypnotherapy with a bit of NLP, a bit of psychotherapy tools as well. So I integrate all that into my program, along with the diet and nutrition and lifestyle, and you know, supplements if they need supplements, or diagnostic testing. All of that is together, which is my path, I guess, as you know, as I've progressed in life as well. All of it seems like everything I've done has been for this moment in time. Yes. It's bizarre, really.
I love it. Because it's so true. Like, I mean, because I'm one of those, like, you know, eclectic fools per se, you know, back in the day. Oh, why are you doing this and why are you doing that? And sort of like going, being led to different parts of understanding. You know, I always loved movement. I always understood movement. I danced, and it was easy for me to kind of pick up things and patterns and just science and nature and the stars. And, you know, so I'm on that sort of like spirituality mix into like trying to fuse that. I always saw these connections, and the same thing, you know, you sit there and I'm like, I would have never thought that I'd be like, you know, yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do all these things, and then I'm going to like run this like virtual goddess tribe. And then I'm going to be like, you know, bringing, you know, it's so funny, but yet it's so perfect. Even the personal relationships up until now, which, you know, leads me to just want to share that, you know, there is that divine design. And you just have to get out of your own way to do it. So what do you think, like, if you could look back now, because I think one of the beauties of menopause is, you know, that permission to sort of really take care of your stuff. Like, I love the way you said, like, I went back to school as a mature student. Like, in America, we'd be like, I went back as, like, I was old, you know, you know? We don't put it anyway nice, but that's beautiful, like, because the words you use, and I love that. You know, looking back, could you think, gosh, with this wisdom, right? Because that's what it is. Experiences make you more mature, hopefully. You know, you're not getting in your own way to learn from them. If you were to talk to, let's say, your guru gal, or you're like your young maiden with that fire of just like, you know, working out or getting all that fitness training, what would you say to her now? That you have as your wisdom now? What would the Pamela today say to that one?
I mean, interesting, because my daughter's 26, isn't she?
Ah, yeah.
You know, she is that girl that's, you know, living life to the full. And I just really adore her and admire what she's doing. And I guess, you know, speaking to somebody like my daughter is to listen to that inner guide and be quiet, you know, have that quiet time. Because if we're busy all the time, we're running from this to that, which I did when I was her age, you know. I had her, you know, I was a mom at 25, and didn't really listen to me often. She was there, I know she was, but I didn't really take that time just to be still and really listen and ask questions. What do you want? What do I want? What's right for me right now? And when you ask questions and you are still and you listen and you wait, the answer comes always, always. But if we're so busy, then we just don't hear it.
Perfect. Such great wisdom there. And, you know, you mentioned that mother-daughter right? Because that's really that, you know, that's like that whole, like, again, even within us, we kind of almost have that mother-daughter relationship constantly with our inner guides. I kind of see them as a holy trinity of the maiden, the mother, and the matriarch is always with us. And they're sort of like this blend together. They kind of come out as needed. But then there's that duality with our inner child. And then I think when we have that daughter in real life, we kind of like get it on the outside and it helps us on the inside and vice versa. Like we have got to kind of work with our own little XX before we're dealing with her XX, because it'll always come out. And you start seeing that, and you know, as they're getting into their maiden fire of teenage and adolescence and stuff. So I look to you, and I think I mentioned that on Instagram, like, oh my God, it's so cute, cool that like you have like a yoga teacher daughter and things like that. Like, I hope for mine I have something like that. Yeah, like, I hope I rubbed off somehow on that, because when they're younger, they're just like, stop, mom, like, I don't want to be like you in adolescence. So like, do you see some of that, I guess, the your reflection in her now? You know, it's easy to say, like what you were saying, like, I remember myself like her. Are you starting to see some peaks, like maybe she's seeing the reflection back now?
Oh my goodness, it's bizarre. Really. You know, when I gave birth to her, I never thought that she would be a woman. And obviously, not really. If you and it's bizarre when I'm with her and when I'm watching what she's doing, I'm thinking, oh my God, you know, that's a little bit of me in her. And it happened just by osmosis. You know, it wasn't something that I dictated to her. She was obviously watching and paying attention. She started doing yoga in a bedroom at age 14.
Beautiful.
I'd got a yoga video and she was doing some exams and she obviously felt stressed, but I didn't know. And I remember going into her bedroom thinking, what is she doing? The bedroom door was shut and she got the yoga video on and she was there doing, oh, you know, 14. It's incredible.
That's great. Yeah, and it's funny because like sometimes you just don't know. I mean, you know, being a mother, you don't know. You're trying to show them, but I found that same thing. It's like the more you push and dictate, because what people don't understand is normal developmental adolescence is about pulling away. Mm-hmm. It is about being a nonconformist, and you're just pushing more. I feel you're just, the more you structure, the more their pushes. And mm-hmm. So not that you should be free at a birth. There needs to be those boundaries because they don't know them. So they need to have something to look at. But I find that like, if, you know, there's just a lot of people, again, getting back to that, I see a lot of people playing out their life, their wishes for their life, mm-hmm. by manipulating their child to do all the things they think that themselves would have been so great. And not realizing that when you're doing that, you're basically aborting that child's ability to live and experience their path. And that divergence into pleasing you or just following your rules to that extent of being you that you couldn't be is difficult, because they have to go back. They have to go back and they're going to have to learn their stuff at some point. And I think sometimes in menopause, I always feel like the unresolved energy, like the stuff you never kind of like did as a younger woman. And, you know, when you get there, I find that those are the people I'm helping clinically more. Mm-hmm. They're having a really hard time in their body. It's like their body saying, I'm resisting this because there's untapped potential or unused knowledge or unrealized, you know, an unresolution of something. Do you find that in your work?
Absolutely. You know, a lot of women really underestimate the emotions and how, when we suppress things, you know, whether they've not been the person they wanted to be because circumstances in their life or they've had trauma, you know, all of that sits within us and we don't realize that could be the root cause of why they feel out of balance when they approach menopause. And so, you know, some of the stuff I do with clients, we go back and we don't relive it, you know, because of hypnotherapy. You don't have to relive the event. We change how the event impacts on you. So what happened back then, we obviously can't change it. But when you talk about it today, if that's still bringing up emotions and feelings inside, then we can change that. We can change the intensity of it through the hypnosis and some of the other work I do. It's really good. And I think once women understand that is part of it, so it's not just about eating the right food, going to bed at the right time, getting out and having fun, it's everything, isn't it? It's a combination of so many different aspects.
So much, because we are a multi-dimensional, multi-system person. And then, you know, you count in, it's like we are constantly reminded of that. It's really sad how we don't celebrate more, you know, getting our menstrual and what that actually means. It's like a constant reminder, you know, of your cycle in the cycle of life, and people don't embrace that. They get like anxious about it, want to be in denial about it, and that's some of that masculinization of the process. And I think that, you know, then all of a sudden then they're faced with losing it, and that deep in our cells of what that means to us. You know, it's a bit of some people I finally get it. It's a grieving process almost they have to go through, understanding that. But there is that, you know, that when I was speaking with Michelle Lyons, you know, that lifting of the veil we were talking about in, it was episode, what was it? I don't know, 7, 8, somewhere in there, Michelle Lyons. But we were talking about the lifting of that veil. You know, you get this wonderful ability to, like, not give an F as much anymore. And so you're just like, you know, you start seeing things and then maybe taking those opportunities. Maybe you're in a different phase of life. I think it's confusing now because some people aren't even starting their mothering until, you know, 35, 40. I mean, Janet Jackson just had a baby at 50. You know, you're in a... It's kind of hard because we're trying to shift so much. But you're right, you know, it's looking at all that, and I just, you know, the power of thought, you know, that's what that hypnotherapy is, the power of thought. And people don't realize all of that chemistry that you actually have control over. You know, when we're doing food, that's just chemistry too. Sleep, that's chemistry. This is all chemistry. And the funny thing is I hated organic chem. And here I am. I hated physics and I hated organic chem and I loved everything else of school. And here I am every single day with the yoga poses and it's all physics and the biochemistry, functional medicine. It's like, again, our path, right? I should have known the things I hated the most I'd be doing for the rest of my life. So Pamela, what do you think, like, at this point, you know, you spoke about seeing their challenges and there must have been a pain that you flipped to bring you to this, because I know that I saw some things like testimonials on you helping people through birth and this and that. So what was there a little area of vulnerability that you had to learn through or something that sort of gave you this mission and this solidity in purpose at the other end of in the menopause? And
I mean, for me, I think it's a reflection of who I was as a child. My child was quite traumatic. My dad was a bear, so it was a bear that came home every night and we didn't know what to expect. So childhood was a pretty tough time. And I think also being born in the 1960s, late 60s,
I hear you. I'm 72. I'm almost right there with you.
And in the UK, and obviously there was lots of racism around in that time. So, you know, I was led to believe as a young woman growing up in that society that, one, I wasn't pretty enough. I wasn't attractive enough. My body shape was wrong, you know, and I believed all of those things that I was told. And I think now as a woman in her early 50s, 51, and approaching, thank you.
I just clapped for those of you who can't see the video.
And, you know, just the start of perimenopause, I think that what I experienced as a young woman growing up in society is pretty much what women, all women, experience today. You know, in terms of the media, we're not represented in the media, and I wasn't as a young woman, as a black young woman here in the UK, wasn't represented in the media, and women today of a certain age aren't. And, you know, we're criticised for not looking right, having grey hair, or not, or dyeing your hair, or being overweight, or being too thin. And I think it's kind of a reflection of that, which kind of gives me the driving force to do it. But then my own health journey of being unwell, and I've, you know, become a woman's health coach on Jessica's course, and Jessica also was my coach, health coach, and we're still working together as well. And so that's been a year of working with Jessica and improving my health. And, you know, she's been a godsend to me, because at the time I didn't know what was wrong. The NHS didn't have any solutions, and, you know, I was ill and that was it. You know, there was nothing else I could do about it. And so everything that I've learned, everything I did with Jessica, I know now that I've actually had a viral fatigue, and, you know, we're working on improving my immune system, my gut health, and it's all coming together now. And a year later, I just feel like I, you know, come out of the ashes, you know, just feel so different. I feel excited about my future. I know that you can improve your health no matter where you are. And I think women who are perimenopausal, menopausal, they think, because we've been told that, no, you have to feel like this, you know, you have to feel low energy, you have to feel fat, there's no solutions other than conventional medicine. And I know from where I was a year ago that there is hope, and you can change it. So I think a mixture of my past childhood and where I've come from the last year, being really unwell, and to where I am today, I think it all combines together. That I just want to say no.
That's awesome. And no is a whole sentence.
Yes.
And just say no. You don't have to explain yourself. So that's awesome. But, and, you know, you were mentioning Jessica. That's Jessica Drummond and her program, Integrative Women's Health Institute, which we took. What you're describing is that difference of finding people such as us trained in, you know, functional medicine application of a woman's health, as opposed to maybe more, you know, westernized, mainstream, allopathic, disease determined symptom management, and the difference that can make. Because you can be, you know, if you don't find the root, if you're not finding that there was a, and I had a, you know, I'm listening to you and I'm like, my God, she's like my sister, my cosmic sister. Like, we had such a similar tie into how we're supposed to be medicine women in this world. And, you know, I had a bad Epstein-Barr, you know, episode, and it titered, like I must have gotten exposed before that too, and just crashed. And, you know, so I know now, oh God, that postpartum depression was tied to that back at, you know, 20 years old, and my subsequent probably adrenal fatigue for being so type 1 and having 10 letters after my name by the time I was like 24 years old. And, you know, then, you know, so like, I understand that now, but like, that's not how I was treated. I was treated with my, you know, here, maybe we can give you, you know, a medication for the depression. And then, you know, maybe we, you know, that's just how it is. Or, you know, you have a new baby, or it's the change your work hours, or, you know, and so, oh gosh, you know, like, I feel like, okay, if nobody else listens to me right now, at least I can tell my daughter this stuff. You know, because it has to start young. Yeah. You know, that's the thing. When you're at menopause working with women, that's one thing. But like, this is a story about how you're perceiving yourself, like you said, from a child.
Yeah.
And then like looking, and then, you know, so help the mother so that she can be the mirror for the child. It's not about perfection. No, 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 no. It's about knowing and just, you know, seeking. Wanted to seek instead of just pacify. You know, with that glass of wine or that repetitive behavior or that obsessive not, you know, self-sabotage.
Yeah.
Really. So, you know, thank you so much for, you know, meeting that. And that's, you know, I there's going to be the people, the leaders are going to be the people that kind of, okay, I got to get done with my own stuff because there's juiciness here and I feel pulled, but it's not easy. Would you agree? It's not an easy road to take or box to get on.
it's not easy at all, but it is doable.
Right. It is doable, but finding those guides, like just letting people, there's people out there, you know, contact me, contact Pamela. We have an international global network that we share, that we can find you somebody, or at least a reference point to move from, instead of just Googling Dr. Google with what you're going to see there is confusing, even if there's good stuff. I want to finish off with something, a couple things I want to mention. Let me know about. I saw on your Instagram today you have a podcast. Is that correct?
Yes. It's called 3D Woman, and I've collaborated with a physiotherapist here in the UK, Catherine Peden, her name is, and she's specializing in women's health, pelvic floor health. And where it's 3D Woman because we wanted to talk about women like holistically.
Yeah.
3D basically. So it's not just about health. In fact, the interview that I talked about on Instagram today is one interview that I did with a woman's a relationship specialist. So she's obviously works with couples, and so it was, we were talking about relationships and relationships, how to maintain a healthy relationship with your partner when perhaps you are that perimenopausal years or menopause, and you've got aging parents that also need your help, and you may have young families because, like you say, a lot of women start to have children later, you know, and how do you maintain your partner, keeping that going, and you know, all the energy around that. So it was really, really interesting. And so we've got lots of different specialists. We've got another specialist that's talking about breast care, but how to look after your breast if you're running, and then we've got skincare specialists. So it's really exciting, actually.
That sounds great. Awesome. That sounds like a perfect goddess tribe secondary tie in to this whole thing of the spirit and the soul and the stuff. So I look forward to listening to that. I'm very, very excited. So is there anything else you're working on right now? Like, how can we find you? What are you doing? Where do we work with Pamela, or just learn some more stuff from her?
Yes, you can find me online. My website is www.smarterchange.co.uk, and currently I'm hosting or running a test program. It's called Wake Up Feeling Refreshed, and it's online, so it's in Kajabi, so a private membership site, and it's a really short little course, give you some really sound information of how to, you know, regain that energy that you might feel a bit sluggish in the morning, and have the best night's sleep and wake up feeling refreshed. So lots of juicy stuff in there. And we have a little private Facebook group as well, where you can ask me questions, and you can find that on my website. And the test is going to run up until the 20th of October, so it'll give you enough time to start to implement some of the things that I'm going to share with you in the membership site. It's really exciting. We've got some really great women in there already that are exploring, you know, oh my god, I didn't realize I ate so many carbohydrates, or I didn't realize that when I went to wee every, you know, three times a night, that was part of part of the reasons why, you know, I can't sleep. So it's really, really good, actually. And I work with clients one-to-one. So I work with clients either online, we use private meeting rooms such as Zoom or Skype, and also work with clients one-to-one here in the UK as well. So the best place to contact me really is my website. There's lots of freebies there as well. There's a lovely hypnotic recording that I've written, and it's about the menopause, and I talk about how it's a natural process. It's just like puberty in reverse, and you've got all these wonderful tools that you can use to help you through that time as well. So you can download that. And I've also got a ebook as well with lots of great information of how to manage your menopausal symptoms too.
Awesome. Why would you not go to her website? There sounds like there's such awesomeness over there. Well, thank you so much, Pamela, for being here and sharing your story and your journey and your wisdom. I'm so, so appreciative of the wonderful women that I have on this. And I will have all the information for you guys on the show notes. You can check the Libsyn page, clicks, and, you know, contact either of us if you need any information on any of this, because it's so, so important. And the best thing you can do is share this out, or at least let another woman know that you see is suffering through some of the things we talked about, to find one of us somewhere, find something like that this stuff is out there. Share this episode, share our websites, and let them know they're not alone. So thanks so much, guys. Thank you very much, Pamela, for being there. Have an awesome rest of your day, guys. See you next time. Bye.
Thank you for listening into this episode of Owning Her Health with Dr. Lisa Holland, PT. To learn more about her personal and professional development service, visit her online at drlisahollandpt.com.